In this video, I would like to explain the peer review or the evaluation of the short papers that you all submitted in the scope of our non-technical project seminar. So in the former years, we did this with printed papers. So every student submitted 3 copies of his own paper with the author removed. So it's an anonymous double-blind peer review. So you usually not know who is the author of your reviewed paper, and you also not know by which persons your own paper is reviewed. And so for this review with this printed papers, we used this evaluation sheet. It has 2 pages, so first page and second page. And there was a field where you could fill in the title of the paper that you review, and each paper also got some number, and there were certain questions, and we will look at these questions in a minute. So some questions on the first page, some more questions on the second page, and then there was a field where you could put in some comments about the paper and where you should also briefly summarize it. And then, of course, we as the organizers or the supervisors of the seminar, we should know who reviewed whom and who was the reviewer for which paper and so on and so on. So this information would be written here on the bottom of the page. So what was the name of the reviewer, what was his or her matriculation number, and the date and the signature. And then we would cut the paper at this line. The students would only get back the upper part with the review score and the information about their paper, and we would keep this lower part for ourselves. And now we will do this review online. So in our e-learning course, we will find the same questionnaire. Still, I would like to discuss the questions here with this form because I think it's a little more clear just from the presentation. But in the e-learning course, you will find exactly the very same questions. So let's have a look at these questions. And the explanation is given here. You should answer all questions carefully. And each positive answer is a point, a plus point, let's say. And each negative answer is just no point. And then at the end, you would just count all the points. Here with this paper review, you would have to do it yourself. Of course, the e-learning system will count the points automatically. And then all the points give a final grade or final result. And if you say no, then it's usually a negative answer. And this negative answer should be commented at the specific place on the paper. And therefore, each question has such an abbreviation. So if you whatever think that the topic of the paper is not well explained, then you mark this corresponding position at the paper. I think you should be also able to do it by commenting the PDF in the online course and say, okay, there the paper is not well explained, or you put this abbreviation there, the ID of this question, and then the author knows, okay, at this position in the paper, the text is maybe not so clear and my topic should be more better explained. And of course, if you give random or thoughtless answers, this will result in failing the seminar. So let's have a short look at all these questions. So it's structured. There are some questions about the content. Is the paper of the topic well explained? I think this is clear. Is there made use of proper visualization? Are there nice figures? Are there maybe nice photographs? Do they have a good quality? Do they help in understanding the topic? Is the short abstract clear? Does it describe what the paper is all about? And is the title clear? Is the title appropriate? Are there maybe strange abbreviations in the title that you do not understand? Are there typos in the title, for example, something like this? Okay, so then each paper should have an outline. Yeah, so the titles of the sections. So you will check, is there an introduction into the topic? Is there a main section or maybe 2 main sections? And are there some conclusions, or is there a summary given? Are the titles of these sections all meaningful? Again, do they maybe contain strange abbreviations, strange words that do not help in understanding the topic? Is the paper logically structured? Means, does the introduction come first, or does the paper begin with a summary, which would be very strange, and does the work have an appropriate scope, means is there some meaningful beginning and some meaningful end, or is it just random information put into a paper, or does everything at least seem to fit together? This is meant by this. So then there are some questions about the expression. So is the written language of good quality? Are the sentences all well readable, or is it sometimes confusing or puzzling or difficult to understand? Are the technical terms chosen or for the topic chosen correctly? Are they appropriate? Or is it let's say, for example, a topic that deals with physics but contains lots of technical terms from medical sciences? This would be very strange. Is the orthography correct, or are there very many spelling mistakes? Is the grammar accurate? Are all the sentences correct and well readable? And planking and clamping means, in the English language, we usually have no space before dots, before periods, before question marks, before commas, but we always have a space after periods, after commas, like here, after question marks, and so on. And so if this space here, for example, would be missing, we would call this a clamp. And on the other hand, if there would be a space before this comma here, or if there would be a space before this period here, we would call this a plank. And this is what we sometimes see in student writing, but it's not good. So please check if the paper that you review, if it's free from this planking or clamping. So then there are some questions about the introduction. Is the topic clearly explained and stated in the introduction? And the introduction should usually also give a brief overview of the work. So in this section, this will be explained. In this section, this other detail will be explained. So some at least brief overview of the work should be given. Okay, so then let's look at the questions on the second page. And there are some questions about the main body or the main sections of the paper. And this main part should be clearly distinguished and separated from the introduction and from the conclusion. So please check if this is the case. The main section or the main sections, they should also contain all the main statements and should discuss all the main results of the work. Please keep in mind you're reviewing a one-page paper, so how many statements will be in there? Maybe just one, maybe two. So don't be too critic about this. Next question is, are the main statements and results critically discussed in the main body? Again, how critically you can discuss certain statements in a one-page paper? But there should be something like this. Then please check if all figures and all tables feature a caption, some explanation, and all figures and tables should also be referred to in the text. So it should be somewhere said, this and this is displayed in figure one, this and this is summarized or given in table one. Then in the conclusion, there should be a brief summary given of the main results of the work or of the paper. And please check if there's also a short outlook given. And for the literature, is a bibliography given? Are some references given? Are all the items in this bibliography related to in the text, or are they just random selected references that don't have to do anything with the topic of the paper? Then, of course, all other papers, articles, books, whatever, that appear in the list of references, they should also be correctly cited in the text in square brackets. And every reference should have an author. The author can also be an institution like Wikipedia or the IEEE, for example. If many authors, many persons contributed to a certain standard or whatever. Each reference should have a title and it should have a year when the source was published, so that people know, okay, who wrote this, what is it about, and how actual it is. And maybe also some way on how to access this source, so some URL for electronic sources or a publisher for books, something like this. Okay, and then please also check the layout of the paper that you review. Are all the layout requirements met? Is the font size correct? Is the font the right font? Is the text alignment okay? And so on and so on. Is the paper looking good? Is the layout style appropriate and appealing, or does it look somehow strange? And is the format consistent throughout the paper, or do we sometimes have this font and then we have another font, and sometimes we have left aligned text and then we have justified text, and this would be somehow strange. And so, as said, the e-learning tool would then automatically calculate all the points. Here on this paper sheet, you would now fill in, okay, for content, we have this and this points, and count or summarize or add all the points to the final sum. And then 0 to 14 points means failed, and so on and so on. And 29 or 30 points means excellent. And to be honest, in the years before, we never had a student fail because he had too few points in his paper. So, to think about this a little more in detail, it's always good to look at some example. And to do this, I have written a paper myself with rather bad quality, and it's about how do soap bubbles develop. So this is the full paper, one page. As you can see, there's some abstract, there's some introduction, there is a main section, there are two figures, there's a table, there are even some formulas, there's a conclusion, and there are some references. It's difficult to read here, of course. So now I will zoom in a little bit, and we will have a look at each section. And we will start with the abstract. And the abstract looks like this. And please stop the video to read this abstract and to think about it. What do you think? What is correct? What is maybe not correct? And how to improve it, or how would you review it? Okay, so let's take a look at this and let's discuss this. So there is one first paragraph here that has nothing really to do with an abstract. An abstract should be a brief summary of what your work is about, what people can expect from your work, from your paper, from your report. And this is something that more belongs into the introduction. Yeah? So this explains what soap bubbles are and how they can be generated, and so on and so on. This is nothing that really describes your work in your paper. So this has nothing to do with an abstract. This belongs to the introduction. The second paragraph, I think it's okay. It nicely explains what this paper is about and what content can be found in the paper. And then we also have some index terms, some keywords that people could use to search for your paper or for this paper in the literature database. And there we can, there you can see we also have some technical terms like this and surface tension and so on. So lots of technical terms appropriate to the topic. Okay, so next is we should have a look at the introduction. And again, I would encourage you to stop the video for a second to read the introduction yourself, to think about what is good, what is bad, and then continue with the video. So if we take a look at this, the first paragraph reads quite good, but there is something here. Another practical application is not known to me. And this is like active speech or direct voice. And this is usually what we do not have in scientific papers. You have no I and me, and usually also not we in scientific papers. It's always something has been done, and if you sometimes want to give your personal impression, then you would write something like another practical application is not known to the author, but not I have done or not to me, something like this. And then we have a second paragraph. This a little bit, this explains which information can be found in which section. And you might have noticed that the problem here is that the format is not correct. So this text here is justified and this text here is left aligned. And this is some common problem in Word that you do not care really about the format and the template, and then sometimes it automatically changes, and then of course it does not look good. Okay, so then we will come to the next section, and the next section looks like this. And again, please stop the video for a second, read the text and continue. And if you do so, and if we take a look at this one here, so there are very many mistakes in there. For example, bubbles is spelled or starts with some uppercase with some capital letter, but should not be. Then we have a typo here, generated. Again, blowing device, this is an uppercase letter, which should be lowercase. Then we have a clamp here. Surface intention is again some words that are capitalized without any reason. Here we have again a clamp. This is again capitalized here. At higher, the R is missing. This is capitalized without no reason. Another typo here. And there's a space missing. This is again a clamp here between this word and this citation with the square brackets. Okay, then we have a figure. What's the problem with this figure? As you notice, the figure quality, the resolution of this photo is very bad. And the figure is not centered. It should be centered. But at least the figure has a caption, which is also quite meaningful. You might ask, why is there no source given here for this figure? Because I'm the author of this paper. I created this figure myself. It's a photograph that I did. If there is no source given at the caption or whatever, the close to the figure, within the figure, we would always think, or people would always assume, that this figure has been created by the author themselves or himself or herself. Okay, so then we have some formulas. Again, please stop the video for a second, look at these formulas, think about it, what is right, what is wrong, and continue with the video. Okay, and if you look at this, you will notice that this formula here is not so nice because we have lower dots for the multiplication. This should be vertically centered dots. And also here the exponent is not so nice because it should be a superscript 2, not with this in this form with the exponent. And we have a second formula. Second formula is more or less okay. Here we have a good exponent, but take care, both formulas are numbered with the number one, which of course doesn't make too much sense. Okay, so let's continue on the other side of this paper with this figure. And what's the problem with this figure? It has a good resolution. It is centered, but there is no caption. And if there is no caption, of course, this figure can also not be referred to in the running text. By the way, if we go back to figure one, we also see that there's figure one here, but the reference to this figure one, we do not find it anywhere in the text. So it should be probably somewhere here saying, okay, so bubbles can be generated using this blowing device, see figure one, but so figure one here is without any connection to the text. So the reference to this figure in the text probably at this position here is missing. Okay, so This figure is missing the caption, therefore there can also be no reference in the text. Then we have a table. Take a look at the table, think about it. Let's have a look at this table. First problem here is it says the following table. Figures and tables are floating objects. They do not necessarily have to appear at the position here. So this table does not necessarily need to follow this text. Sometimes the table can also move up or move down where there's good space in the paper. That's why we would always say table 1 summarizes these and other parameters. Next problem is the table caption should be above the table, not below the table. Why? Tables can also be sometimes a little longer and go over several pages or several columns, and then it does not make too much sense to have a table, and then following the table caption below the table. So that's why you want to have the table caption above the table. Figures instead, like this photograph, they do not go over several pages, so it's always okay to have the figure caption below the figure. And then the table here has just very bad quality. It's not really a table, it's inserted as a figure, as a raster graphic, as you can see. So bad resolution, would look bad when printing. Then the question is, so we always have these horizontal lines here, but here it's missing. There's a typo here for this area, and then the alignment of the columns is totally senseless. So here it's centered, but here it should probably be aligned to the left. Here, it with these numbers, it would make more sense to align it to the right, and maybe with these units, it would be better to just center them. So this is not formatted very nice, and then you can see, for example, that this is in bold and this is in boldface, but here this table heading is not in boldface. So it's not a good style. It's not a good design. Okay, so let's come to the next section. Take a look at this, or stop the video, take a look at this, think about it, and continue with the video. So this section is about a mixed reality installation of soap bubbles. And it explains how virtual soap bubbles can be created. So from the content, it's totally nice, but what is the problem here? It's a different font. It's not the font that we have in the rest of the paper. And so the format is not good. We will also later on see another problem with the section, but we will come back to this later. Now, if we take a look at this section here, what's the problem with this? If you read this, it sounds a little bit like you studied 3 semesters of Judaistic. It sounds like Master Yoda would talk this. Yeah, soap bubble is not very stable. This is bad grammar. This is bad style. And another problem is this should be some itemization, but there are no real bullet points. It's just these hyphens, and also the alignment here is not good. Yeah, so here is just one space, and here there are 2 spaces, and that's why grammar is bad. Sentences are not well readable, and the alignment here is not good. Okay, so let's have a look at the conclusion and at the references. Stop the video, take a look at it, think about it, and continue with the video. And if you do so, you see, okay, the conclusion is quite good from the content, but the problem is with the style. If you compare this font and this font, the conclusion is in a smaller font. The font size changes, which is again, of course, not good, not good format. If we take at the references, the references, I think, look very good. So we have 2 sources. The source has an author, the source has a title, it has a year when it's published, it has some way how to access the source, And it also shows the date when this source was accessed, because websites, electronic sources, they can change over time. And yeah, this is just the year when we offered our seminar the first time. This is when I created this paper. And then we have a second source, which is really a scientific paper. So yeah, I really searched the IEEE Explorer Digital Library, and I was able to find a paper, a scientific paper that deals with soap bubbles. And this is this, if you remember what we have seen in the section before, this jellyfish party, soap bubbles in mixed reality space. And now we come back to this section here and see, okay, we don't have any reference to this source in the text. Yeah, so the citation of this jellyfish party and what is given here, this is missing. So there should be a square bracket 2, maybe here or maybe there or maybe somewhere in this section. Here for reference number 1, we have this citation. Okay, so that's all. For looking at this paper, now we could go back to the score sheet and yeah, discuss a little bit how would we review, how would we grade this paper. So, is the topic of the paper well explained? I would say so, yes. Is made use of appropriate visualization when possible? I would say no, because if you remember this figure here, this is really bad quality. This could be better. Is the abstract clear? I would also say no, because if you remember this first paragraph of the abstract, this would something that does not really belong to the abstract. That would more fit into the introduction. So here I would also say no. Is the title appropriate? The title is totally okay, so we would say yes. Outline, is there an introduction, a main body, and a summary and conclusion? What would you say? I would say yes. Are the titles of the sections meaningful? Yes. Is the paper logically structured? Again, if we take a look at the full paper, logical structure seems meaningful, so we would say yes. And does the work have an appropriate scope? What do you think? I would say also yes. Then we should grade the written language. Is the written language of appropriate quality? Not everywhere. That's why I would say no. Are all the sentences well readable? I would also say no. Are the used technical terms appropriately chosen to the topic? I would say yes. Is the orthography correct? Not always. We have lots of these spelling mistakes. Grammar is also not everywhere correct. And is the text free from plinking or clamping? Unfortunately, not, because we had lots of clamps here in this section. So if we remember, no, we will continue with the introduction. And say, is the topic clearly stated in the introduction? Yes, the introduction is okay. And is a brief overview of the work given? Yes, because here we have this brief overview. So if we count the points, then we have, if I remember correctly, 3 points for this first section. And we had 4 points for this section. No, we had just 2 points for the first section. And here we had just 1 point, unfortunately, for this section, and we had 2 points for this section. So let's come to the second page for the body. Is the main part clearly distinguished from the introduction or from the conclusion? I would say yes. Does the main body contain all main statements and results of the work? I would also say yes. Are the main statements critically discussed in the body and the results as critically as one can do it in a one-page paper? I would also say yes. Do all figures and tables feature a caption? Unfortunately not. We had this figure here without a caption. And do all figures and tables are referred to in the text? No, because a reference to this figure and to this figure is missing, and here the reference is also not that nice. So we have 3 points for this section. Let's review the conclusion. Is a brief summary of the main results given? Definitely. Is an output given? No, unfortunately not. So 1 point there. Then if we answer the questions with respect to the literature, is a comprehensive bibliography given? Yes, we have 2 sources. Are all the items related to in a text? Yes, they all belong or have something to do with the text. Are all citations in the text marked correctly? No, unfortunately not, because here the citation of the second source is missing. And does each reference has an author, a title, and a year of publication? Yes. So we have 3 more points for this section. And if we grade the layout, are all the layout requirements met? So proper font size, text alignment, choose of font. No, unfortunately not, because font is changing. Sometimes it's too small and the text is sometimes aligned to the left. And so on. Is the layout style appropriate and appealing? No, not really, because the table, if we remember, the table, the table looked bad. And here these formulas, for example, have wrong numbers. And these bullet points here, they are not so good. That's why here I would say no. And is the format consistent throughout the paper? Also no. So unfortunately, we have 0 points here from this section. But if we summarize, we had 2 here for the content, 4 for the outline, 1 for the expression, 2 for the introduction, 3, no, I missed one. Ah, we have, ah, okay, 3 for the body, 1 for the conclusion, 3 for the literature, and 0 for the layout. So if we sum this all up, You might be faster in your head than me. We have 6 and 8 and 9 and 10. And so we end up with 16. And 16 means, okay, it's bad, but not failed. Yeah, so this is good. So finally, to conclude this video, we can have a look at the good paper, because I, of course, also prepared a good version, a better version of this paper. This was the bad version. This is the good version. So again, if I zoom in here a little bit, and if you like, you can stop the video in between to read this, but I would just shortly go through this. Now the abstract is more clear. It just focuses on what the paper is about. So this, what we had before, has just been moved into the introduction. So the introduction a little bit then explains what soap bubbles are, and the sentence here is corrected. Another practical application is unknown to the author of this paper. Still, I forgot, we have these index terms which have been there before and which are quite nice. Then we have the section that explains the structure of the paper. Then we have this first main section. Now all the typos have been corrected. Yeah, so the we don't have these arbitrarily capitalized words in the text anymore. We have a reference to figure 1. We have all these clamps removed and spaces inserted. And we also have a reference to the second figure. Now, this first figure has a much higher resolution, looks much better. It's centered. The formula has been corrected, so we have these vertically centered multiplication dots here and there, and the exponent is correct, and formulas are also numbered correctly with 1 and 2. Now this sentence says table 1, not the following table, because as you can see here, now the table does not follow the sentence anymore. Okay, it follows on the next column, but table 1 summarizes these and other parameters. So we have this figure, as said, it now has a caption explaining this interference that occurs with the light in the soap bubbles. Again, it's a picture that I have created myself, a photograph that I have created myself, so no reference here, because it's my own photograph. Now the table also looks much nicer. The table caption is above the table. We don't have these vertical lines anymore. We just have horizontal lines. The alignment of the columns is more meaningful. I said this is aligned to the left. This is this is aligned to the right. This is also aligned to the left. And the table head is always bold and centered. And this is now directly inserted as a table into the text. So if I zoom in, you see that it's much better quality than the table that we had before that was just inserted as a picture. Now we have this proper citation of the second source here in this text. Here the grammar has been corrected. And we have real bullet points for this itemization here, which looks much better than just the hyphens that we had before. Now the conclusion also has the right and proper font size as the rest of the text, and also a very brief outlook is given, as brief as it can be for a one-page paper, and the references did not really change to the bad version that we had before. So please, for your review, also take a very detailed look on the papers of your fellow students. And take care when filling in and answering the questions of this review sheet in the electronic form in our e-learning course. Thank you.